Welcome to the ENS Camera iOS app tutorial. Step 1. Go to the App Store and download the ENS Camera app to your iPhone or iPad. In the second step, you will need to set up your app and camera. Turn on the ENS Camera by the use of the magnet. Look for the magnet indication and hold the magnet flat against the cover glass for at least 2 seconds. Then wait until the camera flashes twice. Open the ENS Camera app and click the Reconnect button in the upper right corner, then accept the pop-up by clicking Join. Go to Company Information and enter all required information about your company. This information will be shown in the title and subtitle of the videos. The email address will be used for the mail notification, so make sure your spelling is correct. Click the Back button to save your information. Step 3. Record a cloud order. When the app and camera is properly connected and set up, you can click the button Cloud Order to start your first order. Except that the ENS Camera app can use your GPS location while using the app. Then enter all information related to the order you're currently processing, as the customer name, order number, and order location. If required, you can add 2 more email addresses that also get access to the ENS Cloud for all videos recorded within this particular order. When finished, click the button Job Information in the lower right corner to navigate to the next page. Here, you can enter the information related to the first job, as the manhole number start, manhole number stop, the cleaning distance, and the pipe diameter. Also, the GPS location will be collected from your smart device and added to the job information. By clicking the Record button, you can then start the recording. When you want to stop the recording, click the Stop button. On the review screen, you can view the video by clicking the Play button. The order protocol gives you an overview about all entered information and recorded videos. By clicking the plus button, you can add another job to your order. From here, the procedure is repeated. Once you get back to the order protocol, you should now have 2 videos in your list. If required, you can delete a video from the list. In case your last video was not good, maybe because your pipe was not completely clean yet, you can retake the same video by clicking the Retake Video button. If you do so, the last video will be deleted and replaced by the new one. The job information will be kept. When you're finished with your order, click Complete Order and the videos will be downloaded from the camera to the smart device. Once the download to your smart device is completed, the videos are available in the video list and the upload to the ENS Cloud starts. Soon, all the entered email addresses will receive their notification and can view and download the videos on the map. If you want to work more efficiently and enter less information, you can activate the GPS-only mode in the settings menu. When you start another cloud order, you will be asked to enter the order information. Once the order information is entered, you can directly start to record the first video. By clicking the plus button on the review screen, the next recording will be started. There's no need to enter any job information, but every job will store your current GPS position. By clicking Complete Order, the videos will be transferred from the camera to the smart device and the cloud upload will be started. If you want to record a video and don't want to upload it to the cloud, you can also record a simple video. The recording will start immediately. On the review screen, you can view the video by clicking the Play button. If you want to keep the video, click the Download button. The video will be added to your video list, but not uploaded to the cloud. Whenever you want to reconnect the smart device to the ENS Camera, click the Reconnect button in the upper right corner and accept the pop-up with Yes. This feature is especially useful to trigger a reconnect when the camera nozzle comes back to the manhole and is in direct line of sight. you can get detailed information about the camera status by clicking the status bar on top of the screen. It will give you further information on your Wi-Fi status, battery percentage, storage capacity, self-test status, temperature and humidity inside of the camera. The video overview lists up all videos recorded with an ENS camera that are stored in the ENS camera app. You can view the videos by clicking on them. To export a video to your phone gallery, click the button below the video. Now the video behaves like a photo or video captured with your smart device's camera and can be transferred to your PC easily. From the icon next to each video, you can determine the type and upload status. Videos can be deleted by the swipe to delete gesture. By clicking the icon in the lower right corner, you can toggle between map and list view so you can find your videos easily at any time. To change your company information as email address, operator name, or truck number, click Company Information. By clicking Delete all videos on the smart device will be deleted. If a video was not uploaded to the cloud yet, it will not be deleted. The Info Help button will take you to the ENS website where you can find further support. Pressing Upload Log Files to Cloud is only required if a technician asks you to do so. The Update Camera Firmware button lets you update the ENS camera's software if a new release is available. By deactivating cellular data upload, your videos will no longer be uploaded to the ENS cloud by GSM, but only if you're connected to Wi-Fi with an internet connection. The No GPS warning can be disabled if you use a device without GPS information. To update the firmware on your ENS camera, connect to your camera and navigate to the settings page. If an update is available, the button Update Camera Firmware is active, and by clicking it, a pop-up tells you the number of the new firmware version. Once the update is started, don't shut down the camera or app until the ENS camera flashed twice and the box FW Info states successfully updated camera. With the next restart of the app, the box FW Info will state your camera is up to date. To display the cleaning distance in the subtitle, enter the known distance between the manhole start and stop in the field cleaning distance in meters or feet. During the cleaning process, completely release the hose pressure for at least 3 seconds when you approach the stop manhole. Then pull the nozzle back with a constant speed and directly stop the video when the nozzle camera is back at the start manhole. The measurement can deviate by 10 to 20%. Use your magnet to shut down the camera. If you need to force the shutdown, hold the magnet next to the indication for 25 seconds.